Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom, there lay a small village at the edge of the woods.
I wish.
And in this village,
more than anything,
lived a young maiden.
More than life, more than jewels.
A carefree lad.
Wish, more than life.
And a childless baker.
I wish.
With his wife.
More than anything, more than the moon, I wish.
The king is giving a festival.
More than life,
I wish. I wish to go to the festival.
More than
life. And the ball.
To give us a cow.
More than anything.
Wish to have a child.
I love a
child. I wish to go to the festival.
I wish we might have a child.
I wish.
It's time to go. I hate to leave. I have to, though. Into the woods, it's time, and so I must begin my journey. Into the woods and through the trees to where I am expected, ma'am. Into the woods
to grandmother's house.
Into the woods
to grandmother's house.
Do you have a basket?
Into the woods and down the dell.
The path is straight, I know it well.
Into the woods and who can tell what's waiting on the journey? Into the woods
to bring some bread.
To Granny who is sick in bed.
Never can tell what lies ahead.
For all that I know, she's already dead. But into the woods.
Into the woods.
Into the woods to grandmother's house and home before dark.
You wish to have the curse reversed?
We'll need a certain potion first.
Go to the woods and bring me back.
One.
The cow as white as milk.
Two.
The cape as red as blood.
Three.
The hair as yellow as corn.
Four.
The slipper as pure as gold.
Bring me these.
Before the chime
of midnight.
In 3 days' time.
'Tis then the blue moon will reappear. That comes but once
each 100 years.
Bring them, and I guarantee
A child as perfect as child can be.
Go to the wood!
Even so, I have to take the journey. Into the woods, the path is straight. I know it well, but who can tell? Into the woods to lift the spell. Into the woods to visit mother.
Into the woods to sell the cow.
To get the money. To go to the festival. Into the woods to grandmother's house. Into the woods to grandmother's house. In the glade there. Into the woods without delay, but careful not to lose the way. Into the woods, who knows what may be lurking on the journey. Into the woods to get the thing that makes it worth the journey. Into the woods to see the king.
So how
to make the potion to see. To get,
to bring,
to make,
to lift,
to go
to the festival,
to get, to get,
to bring,
to make,
to the woods,
to go to the festival,
into the woods,
to get,
to the woods,
to make,
to the woods,
to go to the festival, into the woods, then out of the woods, to see, to get, to make, to go to the festival, into the woods, then out of the woods, and home before dark.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I am John Sauvay, director of the Coppell Community Chorale, and we would like to welcome you to Tipping the Hat, a celebration of Stephen Sondheim's 94th birthday. We are in for a special treat tonight. You just heard the prologue from Into the Woods, performed by our 60-plus members of a chorus, but we are also joined by four rising stars in the DFW Metroplex. Janette Robinson. Rachel Nicole Poole. Johnny DeAndre Brown. And our very own Malcom Payne Jr. We have prepared for you an evening of beautiful songs and thrilling stories by the late, great Stephen Sondheim. He was born March the 22nd, 1930 in New York City. Sondheim's illustrious career spanned 60 years with dozens of awards, including 8 Tonys, 8 Grammys, 16 Drama Desk Awards, and a Pulitzer Prize. His lyrics and music are in the category of their own, historically redefining the American musical. We are thrilled you have chosen to celebrate with us here tonight at Tipping the Hat. Without further ado, our soloists continue the evening performing You're Gonna Love Tomorrow from Follies.
What will tomorrow bring, the pundits query?
Will it be cheery?
Will it be sad?
Will it be Burns in spring or Harakiri?
Don't worry, dearie.
Don't worry.
I'll have a future suit your whim, blue chip preferred.
Putting it in a synonym perfects the word.
We're in this thing together, aren't you glad? Each day from now will be the best. You're gonna love tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna be with me.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna love tomorrow. I'm giving you my personal guarantee.
Say toodaloo to sorrow.
Uh-huh.
And fare thee well, ennui.
Bye-bye.
You're gonna love tomorrow. As long as your tomorrow is spent with me.
Today was perfectly perfect. You say, well, don't go away. Cause if you think you like today, you're gonna love tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Just stick around and see.
Mm-hmm.
And if you love tomorrow, just think of how it's gonna be. Tomorrow's what you're gonna have a lifetime of with me.
Sally dear, now that we're man and wife, I will do wonders to make your life so stirring and free of care.
If we fight and we might, I'll concede. Furthermore, dear, should your ego need so stirring, I'll do my share.
But though I'll do my utmost to see you never frown,
and though I'll try to cut most of our expenses down,
I've some traits, I warn you, to which you'll have objections.
I too have a cornucopia
Oh, oh, I may make a rotten host.
Okay, but no matter what goes wrong,
love will see us through till something better comes along. I may vex your folks.
Okay, I may interrupt your jokes.
You may, but if I come on too strong,
love will see us through till something better comes along.
I may play cards all night and come home at 3.
Just leave a light on the porch for me.
Well, nobody's perfect.
I may trump your ace.
Please do. I may clutter up the place.
Me too.
But the minute we embrace, to love those three is all. Till love will have to do till something better comes along.
Hi.
Girls.
Ben.
Sally.
I may burn the toast.
Oh, well, maybe
you're gonna be with host.
Okay, but no matter what goes wrong,
I'm giving you my personal
something better comes along.
Say toodaloo to sorrow, and fairly well on
me too.
Bye-bye.
As long as your tomorrow is certain, twins will meet
today.
Perfect, you say,
but don't go my way.
If you think you like today,
you're gonna love tomorrow.
You stick around and see,
me too,
but don't mean that you to love tomorrow. Just think of how it's gonna be. Love is what you're gonna have a lifetime.
Into the Woods is filled with laughter, love, and tears. One of Sondheim's most popular works, this story interweaves the lives of your favorite fairy tale heroes and villains. And sometimes, who you think is the hero or the villain turns out to be the exact opposite. Ah, the complexities of human nature. One of Sondheim's most favorite themes. In this next upcoming scene, we meet the handsome and charming... In this next upcoming scene, we will... In this next scene, we meet the two princes from a kingdom far, far away who have found love at first sight. Or maybe just one.
Will you come to me? Brother? Brother? Is that you? Brother!
Please welcome Malcom Payne Jr. and Johnny DeAndre Brown for singing Agony.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony, beyond power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her head. Blithe and becoming, and frequently harming her light-hearted air. Ah, agony, far more painful than yours, when you know she would go with you if there only were doors.
Agony, oh, the torture they teach.
Intriguing.
Or half so fatiguing as what's out of reach. Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and heir to a throne?
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why know?
Do I know?
The girl must be mad.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there all while nearing her, all the while hearing her.
Agony! Well, though it's different for each. Always 10 steps behind.
Always 10 feet below.
And she's just out of reach. Agony! I can cut like a knife. I must have her to
about another man who has trouble speaking the truth about his feelings. Company is a string of vignettes following a 34-year-old bachelor, Bobby, leading up to his surprise birthday party. Often the observer of his friend's sometimes tumultuous relationships, Bobby resists the recurring notion that everybody needs somebody and has condemned himself to the bachelor lifestyle. Along the way, however, Bobby takes his shot at love, and let's just say his attempts are less than perfect. His fear of commitment leads him to relationships with multiple women at one time, none of which are thrilled with his behavior and neurotic tendencies. Welcome to the stage, Ladies Variations performing You Could Drive a Person Crazy from Company.
You could drive a person crazy. You could drive a person mad. First you make a person hazy, so a person could be happy. Then you leave a person dangling sadly outside your door, which it only makes a person gladly want you even more. I could understand a person if he said to go away. I could understand a person if he happened to be gay. But worse than that, a person that titillates a person and then leaves her flat is crazy. He's a troubled person. He's a truly crazy person himself.
You crummy bastard.
You son of a
Bobby is my hobby and I'm giving it up.
When a person's personality is personable, he should not sit like a lump. It's harder than a matador coercinable to try to get you off of your rump. So single and attentive and attractive a man is everything a person could wish. But turning off a person is the act of a man who likes to pull the hooks out of fish.
Knock, knock, is anybody there? Knock, knock, it really isn't fair. Knock, knock, I'm working on my charms. Knock, knock, a zombie's in my arms. What is wrong? Where's the loose connection? How long, oh Lord, how long? Bobby, baby, Bobby, booby, Bobby. You could drive a person buggy. You could blow a person's cool. First you make a person feel all huggy, while you make her feel a fool. When a person says that you've upset her, that's when you're good. You impersonate a person better than a zombie should. I could understand a person if he wasn't good in bed. I could understand a person if he actually was dead. Exclusive you, elusive you. Would any person ever get the juice of you? You're crazy. You're a lovely person. You're a moving, deeply maladjusted, never to be trusted, crazy person.
Giving
it up.
Gypsy is the great American musical based on the real life of burlesque dancer Gypsy Rose Lee. A single mother, Rose, hungry for fame and financial freedom, raises two daughters on the vaudeville stage. One who has the talent, but not the drive. One who also has the talent, but just wants to be seen for who she is and not as a prop. Rose's obsession poisons the relationships among her and her children. In this scene, we see the youthful sisters dreaming about a man who will sweep their mother off her feet and out of their hair. Janette Robinson and Rachel Nicole Poole singing If Mama Was Married.
If Mama was married, I'd live in a house as quiet can be. Just Mama, three ducks, five canaries, a mouse, two monkeys, one father, six turtles, and me. If Mama was married.
If Mama was married, I'd jump in the air and give all my toe shoes to you. I'd get all these hair ribbons out of my hair, and once and for all, I'd get Mama out too. If Mama was married.
Mama, get out your white dress. You've done it before.
Without much success.
Mama, Godspeed and God bless. We're not keeping score. What's one more or less? Oh, Mama, say yes and waltz down the aisle while you
I'll gladly support you, I'll even escort you, and I'll gladly give you away.
Oh, Mama, get married today.
If Mama was married, there wouldn't be any more. Let me entertain you, let me make you smile. I will do some tricks.
I will do some tricks.
Sing out, Louise.
Oh, smile, baby.
Mama,
please take our advice. We aren't the Lunts.
I'm not Fanny Bryce. Mama, who buy you the rice? If just for this once,
you wouldn't think twice.
It could be so nice if Mama got married to stay.
But Mama gets married
and
married
and
married
and never gets carried away. Oh, Mama.
A Little Night Music features four main couples and their romantic entanglements with each other. Frederick and his new young wife, Anne, Desiree and her lover, Count Carl Magnus Malcolm, the Count and his wife, Countess Charlotte, and Desiree and Frederick, who were once lovers and have a child. Bang is an alternative song for the hyper-macho Count Magnus after he discovers his mistress's infidelity with her ex. Infamous for his triumphs over women, the Count plays out the courtship between a dainty damsel and her seductive suitor. His strategic persuasions leads to another successful conquest, proving once again to himself that he is the better man. Please welcome to the stage vocalist Aaron Baker and our lovers tonight, the fabulous duo Henry and Rayleigh.
Terrible to be a woman.
the time is here, the game is there, the smell of fear like musk pervades the air. The bugle sounding, the pistol steady, the blood is pounding, take aim and ready. Bang, 20 minutes small talk, 30 at the most. Bang, two or three to pour the schnapps. Bang, 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 half a minute to propose the necessary toast. Bang, the tunic opens, bang, the trousers fall. Bang, the foe is helpless, back against the wall. Bang, an hour and a quarter over all. And bang, 20 minutes to arrange those idiotic flowers. Can she get away with more? Bang, bang, bang. Then she has to brush her hair, and that could take her hours. Bang, a fit of vapors. Bang, no, that's too quaint. Bang, a racking cough, and then a graceful faint. Bang, a lengthy lecture. Bang, on self-restraint. Bang, 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 bang. The battle rages. Whatever ground he gains, he fortifies remorselessly. The foe engages by shifting the terrain. How pitiful to be a woman. Attack, retreat, lay back, reform, outflank, deplete, move up, and then restorm. The siege succeeding, the time grows shorter. She lies there pleading, he gives no quarter. Bang, foray at the elbow, salvo at the knee. Bang, fusillade at breast and thigh. Bang, 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 and then when she's exhausted, a fresh sortie. Bang, he tastes the conquest. Bang, the taste is sweet. Bang, she lays her arms down, welcoming defeat. Both sides content, secure positions. All passion spent, discuss conditions. How terrible, how pitiful, how glorious to be a woman. He's a peacock, she keeps forgetting. The quarry senses a momentary pang. It's all so foolish, why are they sweating? The war commences. Bang!
Sunday in the Park with George is a story of an artist consumed by his craft. It's inspired by George Seurat, a Sunday afternoon on the island of Grande Jatte. Throughout the show, the audience is privy to the precarious balance, or lack thereof, of personal relationship, professional courtesy, and creative drive. This particular monologue shows George's constant conflict between passion and love. Welcome back to the stage, Malcom Payne Jr. singing Finishing the Hat.
Yes, she looks for me. Good. Let her look for me to tell me why she left me. Like I always knew she would. I had thought she understood. They have never understood, and no reason that they should. But if anybody could. Finishing the hat. How you have to finish the hat. How you watch the rest of the world through a window.
while you finish the hat, mapping out a sky, what you feel like planning a sky, what you hear when voices that come through the window go until they distance and die, until there's nothing but sky, and how you're always turning back too late from the grass or the stick or the dog or the light, or how the kind of woman willing to wait's not the kind that you want to have waiting to return you to the night, dizzy from the height, studying a hat, coming from the hat, entering the world of the hat, reaching through the world of the hat like a window, back to this one from that, studying a face, stepping back to look at a face, leaves a little space in the way like a window, but to see is the only way to see. And when the woman that you wanted goes, you can say to yourself, well, I give what I give. But the woman who won't wait for you knows that however you live, there's a part of you always standing by, mapping out a sky, finishing a hat, starting on a hat, finishing a hat. Look, I made a hat. Where there never was a hat.
Arguably, the most well-known American musical in history, West Side Story is a modern realization of the classic Shakespearean play, Romeo and Juliet. Rather than the countryside of Fair Verona, the retelling takes place in 1950s Upper West Side Manhattan. The star-crossed lovers, Tony and Maria, fall for each other despite the bad blood between their prospective gangs, the Jets and the Sharks. If you know the story, it doesn't end well for them. Sorry for the spoiler, but the play's been out for hundreds of years. And the musical's been around for decades. Acclaimed for its intense demands of dance, music, and drama, West Side Story quickly became an American classic. Sondheim's first success in the musical scene, his lyrics stir our emotions and pull at our heartstrings, making us want to laugh, dance, and even cry. Perfectly married with the orchestration of Leonard Bernstein, memorable hits such as I Feel Pretty, Maria, America, Somewhere and More are part of American history and will set even the hardest cynic to humming along. Please welcome back to the stage the Coppell Community Chorale for selections from West Side Story.
Do you feel pretty, oh so pretty. I feel pretty and witty and bright. It's alarming how charming I feel.
How she feels.
And so pretty that I hardly can believe I breathe.
La 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 la.
See that pretty girl in that mirror there.
What mirror where?
Who can that attractive girl be?
Which, what, where, who?
Such a pretty face, such a pretty dress, such a pretty smile, such a pretty me.
La 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 la.
Running and dancing for joy.
Maria, the most beautiful sound I ever heard.
Maria,
all the beautiful sounds of the world in a single word.
Maria,
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 Maria.
I just met a girl.
I like to be in America, okay by me in America.
As stated earlier, Company follows Bobby in scenes with his coupled friends leading up to his 35th birthday. Each couple has their own issues, focused on for a moment while Bobby struggles with his dueling fears of commitment and dying alone. One such scene is between Joanne, a wealthy older woman, and her newest husband, Larry, the latest in a long line of husbands. They take Bobby to a nightclub, and as Larry dances the night away, Bobby and Joanne get completely smashed, leading Joanne to a witty repartee of the different sorts of women she has come across in her lifetime. The seemingly jestful conversation takes a solemn turn, as Sondheim often does, and she reflects inward on her own personality flaws, landing squarely on the fact that we all live and we all die. Please welcome back to the stage the Variations ladies singing The Ladies Who Lunch.
Lunch up. Thank you. I'd like to propose a toast. Here's to the ladies who lunch. Everybody laugh. Lounging in their caftans and planning a brunch on their own behalf. Is there special?
I know.
Off to the gym, then to a fitting, claiming their fat. And looking grim, 'cause they've been sitting, choosing a hat. Does anyone still wear hats?
You've seen my wall.
Oh, brother. I'll drink to that.
And here's to the girls who stay smart. Aren't they a gas?
They're a hoot.
Rushing to their classes in optical arts, wishing it would pass. Another long, exhausting day. Another $1,000. A matinee, a pinter play. Perhaps a piece of Mahler.
I'll drink to that.
And one for Mahler.
Mahler.
And here's to the girls in their prime. Aren't they too much? Keeping house but clutching a copy of Time just to keep in touch. The ones who follow the rules and meet themselves at the schools, too busy to know that they're fools. Aren't they a gem? I'll drink to them.
Who just watch, aren't they the best?
Rude.
When they get depressed, it's a bottle of scotch, plus a little jest.
We're out of scotch. Is gin okay?
Another chance to disapprove, another brilliant zinger, another reason not to move, another vodka stinger. Drink to that.
I think you're cut off.
And here's to the girls on the go. Everybody tries.
Look into their eyes and you'll see what they know. Everybody dies.
A toast to that invincible bunch. The dinosaur surviving the crunch.
Let's hear it for the ladies to lunch. Everybody
down.
Each storyline within Into the Woods has its own lessons to relate to the audience. Whether it's that home is better than we may think, and we don't realize it until it's too late, like Jack teaches us, or that our own self-reliance is important, but sometimes we do need the help of others, like Cinderella and Little Red. Lessons are sprinkled throughout the show. In this selection, the baker's wife has just had an encounter with Prince Charming, who sweeps her off his feet with little to no regard for others who may be involved. As he leaves her, she realizes things aren't always what they seem, and the grass isn't always greener on the other side. The fairy tale ending she's been yearning for is closer than she thought. Please welcome back Janette Robinson singing Moments in the Woods.
What was that? Was that him? Was that me? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me? And kiss me? And did I kiss him back? Was it wrong? Am I mad? Was it all? Does he miss me? Was he suddenly getting bored with me? Wake up, stop dreaming, stop prancing about the woods. It's not beseeming, what is it about the woods? Back to life, back to sins, back to child, back to husband, no one lives in the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are shouldn'ts and shoulds. Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're clever. Have a child for warmth, and a baker for bread, and a prince for whatever. Never, it's these woods. Chase the facts, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, just get out of the woods. Was that him? Yes, it was. Was that me? No, it wasn't. Just a trick of the woods. Just a moment. One peculiar passing moment. Must it all be either less or more? Either plain or grand? Is it always or? Is it never end? That's what woods are for. For those moments in the woods. But if life were only moments, even now and then a bad one. Oh, but life were only moments, then you'd never know when you'd had one. First a witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment who can live in the woods. And to get what you wish, even just for a moment, these are dangerous woods. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Just remember when you've had an end, and you're back to or. Makes the or mean more than it did before. Now I understand, and it's time to leave the woods.
Follies is a musical of nostalgia and endearment, while former colleagues and current friends gather for the closing of the beloved Wiseman Theater. Old flames are reunited. Ben, the husband of Phyllis, recounts former times with Sally, his former lover, who has attended the reunion with her husband, Buddy, Ben's former best friend. Yeah. Too Many Mornings is one of the most popular standards of the Broadway canon and has Ben and Sally imagining the lives they could have led together. Please welcome Rachel Nicole Poole and Johnny Brown singing Too Many Mornings.
Too many
faking and pretending I reach for you. Thousands of mornings turning into days. All those days that I thought would never end. All those nights with another day to spend. All those times I look up to see standing at the door, Sally moving to the bed, Sally standing in my arms with her head against my head.
When should I get here? How should I find you? Where I'd stand, what I'd say in case you didn't remember, how I'd remind you. You remembered, and my fears were wrong. Was it ever real? Did I ever love you this much? Did we ever feel so happy then?
It was always real.
I should have worn green.
And I've always loved you this much.
I wore green the last time.
We could always be.
The time I was happy.
Pretending I reach for you. How many mornings are there still to come? How much time can we hope that there will be? Not much time, but it's time enough for me.
Our next selection from The Follies occurs after high tensions between Phyllis and Ben rise from an intoxicated encounter with former flings. Ben, unsatisfied in his marriage, admits to longing for another and asks his wife for a divorce. Phyllis contemplates the sacrifices she's made to keep their relationship afloat and rebuttals her husband's request. Please welcome back to the stage Aaron Baker singing Could I Leave You?
Leave you, leave you. How could I leave you? How could I go it alone? Could I waste the years away with a quick goodbye? How do you wipe tears away when your eyes are dry? Sweetheart, lover,
could I recover? Give up the joys I have known. Not to fetch your pills again every day at 5. Not to give those dinners for 10 elderly men from the UN. How could I survive? Could I leave you and your shelves of the world's best books and the evenings of martyred looks, cryptic sighs, sullen glares from those injured eyes, leave the quips with the sting, jokes with the sneer, passionless lovemaking once a year, leave the lies ill-concealed and the wounds never healed and the game's not worth winning and wait, I'm just beginning. Leave you, how could I leave you? What would I do on my own? Putting thoughts of you aside in the south of France. Would I think of suicide? Psh, darling, shall we dance? Would I live through the pain on a terrace in Spain? Would it pass? It would pass. Could I bury my rage with a boy half your age in the grass? That's your ass. But I've done that already. Or didn't you know, love? Tell me, how could I leave when I left long ago, love? Could I leave you? No, the point is, could you leave me? Well, I guess you could leave me the house, leave me the flat, leave me the Brocks and Chagalls and all that. You could leave me the stocks for sentiment's sake and 90% of the money you make and the rugs and the cooks. Darling, you keep the drugs. Angel, you take the books. Honey, I'll keep the graham sugar. You take the spinach and all of our friends and wait a goddamn minute. Leave you, how could I leave you? Sweetheart, I have to confess. Could I leave you? Yes. Will I leave you? Will I leave you? Guess.
And now for something completely different. Sweeney Todd, The Demon Barber of Fleet Street, is a horror comedy musical about revenge and righteousness. Mrs. Lovett, in this scene here we're going to do, Mrs. Lovett runs into the stoic Sweeney outside of her pie shop and proves herself a formidable ally. As they plot the demise of their enemies, she introduces a brilliantly terrifying and kind of icky plan to exact their revenge. Welcome back to the stage, Janette Robinson and Malcom Payne Jr. singing Little Priest.
Well, you know me. Bright ideas just pop into my head and I just get to thinking. Seems a downright shame.
Shame.
Seems an awful waste. Such a nice plump frame. What's his name as had? Has, nor it can't be traced. Business needs a lift. Debts to be erased. Think of it as thrift, as a gift, if you get my drift. No, seems an awful waste. I mean, with the price of meat, what it is, when you get it, if you get it.
Ha!
Good you've got it. Take for instance Mrs. Mooney and her pie shop. Business never better, using only pussycats and toast. And a pussy's good for maybe even 6 or 7 at the most. And they can't compete as far as
taste.
Mrs. Lovett, what a charming notion.
Well, it does seem a waste.
As always, Mrs. Lovett, how I've lived without
you. It's my dear.
I'll never know.
Think about it. Lots of other gentlemen will soon be coming for a shave. Won't they?
How choice. How rare. So what's the sound of the world out there?
What, Mr. Todd? What, Mr. Todd? What is that sound?
Those crunching noises pervading the air.
Yes, Mr. Todd, yes, Mr. Todd, yes, all around.
It's man devouring man, my dear.
Then and who are we to deny it in here?
These are desperate times, Mrs. Lovett, and desperate measures are called for.
Ah, here we are, hot out of the oven.
What is that?
It's priest. Ab little priest.
Is it really good?
Sir, it's too good, at least. Then again, they don't commit sins of the flesh, so it's pretty fresh.
Awful lot of fat.
Only where it's at.
Haven't you got poet or something like that?
No, you see, the trouble with poet is how do you know it's deceased? Try the priest.
Heavenly! Not as hardy as bishop, perhaps, but not as bland as curate, either.
And good for business, too. Always leaves you wanting more. Trouble is, we only get it on Sundays. Oh. Lawyer's rather nice.
If it's for a price.
Order something else, though, to follow, since no one should swallow it twice.
Anything that's lean?
Well, then, if you're British and loyal, you might enjoy Royal Marine. Anyway, it's clean. Though, of course, it tastes of wherever it's been.
Is that squire by the fire?
Mercy, no, sir. Look closer. You'll notice it's grosser.
Looks thicker. More like vicar.
No, it has to be grosser. It's green.
The history of the world, my love.
Save a lot of graves, do a lot of relatives' favors.
Is those below serving those up above?
Everybody shaves, so there should be plenty of blavers.
How gratifying for ones to know
that those above will serve those down below.
Now, let's see here. We've got Tinker.
Something pinker.
Taylor.
Something paler.
Potter.
Something potter.
Butler.
Something subtler.
Locksmith.
Something.
Lovely bit of clock.
Maybe for a lark.
Then again, it's sweet if you want it cheap and you like it dark. Try the financier. Peak of his career.
Ew, that looks pretty rank.
But he drank, it's a bank cashier. Never really sold. Maybe it was old.
Have you any beetle?
Next week, so I'm told. Beetle isn't bad till you smell it and notice how well it's been greased. Stick to priest. Well, this one might be stringy, but then of course, it's a fiddle player.
That's not a fiddle player, it's a piccolo player.
Well, how can you tell?
Because it's piping hot.
Then blow on it first!
The history of the world, my sweet.
Oh, Mr. Todd, what does it tell?
It's who gets eaten and who gets to eat.
And Mr. Todd, yes, Mr. Todd, who gets to sell?
But fortunately, it's all so clear
that everybody goes down well with beer.
Well, since Marine doesn't appeal to you, how about Rear Admiral?
Too salty. I prefer General.
With or without his privates. With is extra.
What is that?
It's fop. Finest in the shop.
while we have some shepherd's pie peppered with actual shepherd on top. And I've just begun. He's a politician so oily, he served with a doily, not one.
Put it on a bun. Well, you never know if it's going to rot.
Try the fryer, bright as dryer.
No, the clergy is really too coarse and too mealy.
No, the actor, that's compactor.
Yes, and always arrives overdone. I'll come again when you have judge on the menu.
Wait, true, we don't have judge yet, but we've got something you might fancy even better.
What's that?
An executioner.
Have charity towards the world, my pet.
Yes, yes, I know, my love.
We'll take the customers that we can get.
High born and low, my love.
We'll not discriminate great from small. No, we'll serve anyone, meaning anyone, and to anyone at all.
Yeah, is this the Dallas County Health Inspector's office? Yeah, I just went to a pie shop, and I think I want to report a health code violation? I don't know, it just seemed kind of suspect. I will call you back. Yeah, okay, thanks. Yeah. A little night music follows the life of Desiree Armfelt, an aging, once sensational actress who spends most of her life on tours away from her young daughter, being cared for by Desiree's mother. The musical explores love in its many forms, through many facets of life. This solo, sung by young Frederica, the daughter of Desiree and Frederick, depicts the perspective of a daughter with a mother committed to showbiz. This is Rachel Nicole Poole singing Glamorous Life.
And sweep the parlor, mend the clothes, and tend the children. Ordinary mothers, like ordinary wives, make the beds and bake the pies and wither on the vine. Not mine. Dying by inches every night, what a glamorous life. Brought on by winches to recite, what a glamorous life. Ordinary mothers never get the flowers, and ordinary mothers never get the joys. Ordinary mothers couldn't cough for hours maintaining their poise. Sandwiches only, but she eats what she wants when she wants. Sometimes she's lonely, but she meets many handsome galants. Ordinary mothers don't live out of cases, but ordinary mothers don't go different places, which ordinary mothers can't do, being mothers all day. Mine's away in a play, and she's realer than they. Her brooches only glass, and her costumes unravel. What if her coach is second class? She at least gets to travel. And sometime this summer, meaning soon, she'll be traveling to me. Sometime this summer, maybe June, I'm the new face she'll see. Ordinary daughters may think life is better with ordinary mothers near them when they choose, but ordinary daughters seldom get a letter in closing reviews. Gay and resilient with applause, what a glamorous life.
speeches are brilliant. If their shawls, what a glamorous life. Ordinary mothers need committees, but ordinary mothers don't get keys to cities. No, ordinary mothers merely see their children all year, which is lovely, I hear, but it does interfere with the glamorous. I am the princess, guarded by dragons, snorting and grumbling and rumbling in wagons. She's in her kingdom, living disguises, living a life that is full of surprises. And sometime this summer, she'll come galloping over the green. Sometime this summer, to the rescue, my mother the queen. Ordinary mothers thrive on being private, and ordinary mothers somehow can survive it, but ordinary mothers don't know that they're just standing still with their kettles to fill while they're missing the thrill of the glamorous.
After spending the show watching his various married and couple friends overcome hardships in their relationships, Company culminates with Bobby having a realization right before his surprise 35th birthday party. He isn't satisfied with a life alone, but he longs for the wonders of love he's seen in his friendships, despite the sacrifices that may be made. Please welcome Johnny Brown singing Being Alive.
So what do you get? Someone to hold you too close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair and ruin your sleep.
That's true, but there's more than that.
Is that all you think there is to it? You've got so many reasons for not being with someone, but you haven't one good reason for being alone.
Come on, you're on to something, Johnny. You're on to something.
Someone to need you too much. Someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short and put you through hell.
You see what you look for, you know.
You're not a kid anymore, Johnny. I don't think you'll ever be a kid again, kiddo. Hey, buddy, don't be afraid that it won't be perfect. The only thing to be afraid of, really, is that it won't be.
Don't stop now. Keep going.
Someone you have to let in. Someone whose feelings you spare. Someone who, like it or not, will want you to care a little, a lot.
And what does that all mean?
How do you know so much about it when you've never been there? It's much better living it than looking at it, Johnny.
Add 'em up, Johnny. Add 'em up.
Someone to crowd you with love. Someone to force you to care. Someone to make you come through, who will always be there, as frightened as you is being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive.
make a wish. Want something. Want something.
Somebody hold me too close. Somebody hurt me too deep. Somebody sit in my chair and ruin my sleep and make me aware of being alive, being alive. Somebody need me too much. Somebody know me too well. Somebody pull me up short and put me through hell and give me support for being alive. Make me alive. Make me alive. Make me confused. Mock me with praise. Let me be used. Vary my day. Crowd me with love. Somebody force me to care. Somebody let me come through. I'll always be there, as frightened as you, to help us survive. Being alive. Being alive.
We would like to extend our heartfelt gratitude for coming out tonight and helping us in this celebration of Sondheim. We hope that Sondheim's words and music have inspired you as it's done to millions before. We ask you to like and follow and share the Coppell Community Chorale on all your social media platforms. And if you like what you saw tonight, please come back for our next performances entitled At the Movies on Saturday, May 11th and Sunday, May 12th. We'd like to thank Janine, Matt, Brian, and Emma, and the rest of the Arts Center staff, along with our tech and our director, John Solvay. And we'd also like to thank the show production committee, the board of directors, and the chorale for their hard work. And now, our time together has finally come to an end. We would like to thank our soloists for tonight, Rachel Nicole Poole. Johnny Brown. Janette Robinson. And Malcom Payne Jr. We'd also like to thank our accompanists, John Tatum and Caroline Moss. Our dancers tonight were Henry and Ray Lee. Order.
Design. Balance.
Harmony.
Sunday, blue, purple, yellow, red, water.
Thank you all for coming this evening. We were remiss and we did not do this last night, so we are going to do this tonight. One person that needs to come out and take her bow is Coppell's own Miss Erin Baker. Thank you for showing your talent with us tonight. Where'd you end up? Come on, Miss Baker.